Find the volume of a cube with a side length of 8xy squared. So we have a cube right here, and they're saying that each of the sides, for a cube, all of the sides have the same length, each of them have length 8xy squared. So the length of this side, maybe we call this the width, is 8xy squared. The length of this side, maybe we can call that the depth, or the length, depending on how you want to label it, is 8xy squared. The height of this cube, well, is also going to be 8xy squared. A cube, all of the dimensions are the same. Now, if you want to take the volume of any rectangular prism, you'll multiply these three dimensions. You'll multiply the width times the depth times the height. Now, in a cube, these are all the same dimension. So you can just take this dimension and multiply it by itself three times. Or you could take it to the third power. So the volume of this cube, is 8xy squared. I could just multiply it by itself three times, or I could say, well, or to the third power. That's why raising something to the third power is called cubing it, because you're essentially finding the volume of a cube where the thing that you're cubing is the dimension of each of the sides. Now, what's this going to be? Well, when you take a product and you raise it to some power, you can, that's the same thing as taking each of the terms to that power. So this is the same thing as 8 to the third power times x to the third power times x to the third power times y squared to the third power times y squared to the third power. And what's 8 to the third power? That's the same thing as 8 squared is 64, so we'll multiply 64 times 8. 64 times 8, 4 times 8 is 32. 6 times 8 is 48, plus 3 is 51, so it's 512. So this is equal to 512 times x to the third, and y squared to the third power, that's the same thing as y to the 2 times 3 power, or y to the 6th power, or y to the 6th power, y to the 6th power. And we're done. We found the volume of the cube. It's 512 x to the third, y to the sixth.